Hello children, welcome to computer class and we are learning MS Access. In our last class, we had studied the queries and we had learned how to do multiple queries and also use double tables, multiple tables and create queries. Today, we are going to learn another new object of MS Access, which is the forms. But before that, there is a very important announcement I need to make. That is regarding your Diwali projects. It has come to our notice that many of the students, especially from B division, C division, F and G divisions, have still not submitted the Diwali project on internet. You were supposed to be doing it in Google Classrooms, but we have still, many students have not submitted. So all those students whose names the teachers have put up in the WhatsApp group, please submit your project at the earliest. These projects are to be considered as the semester 1 marks. So that is why it is very important for you to do these projects. Please submit those who have submitted it already, no problem. But those who have not submitted it and whose names were given by the class teachers, please do submit it at the earliest. So this is what one announcement which we wanted to make. The project was on internet. You have to write about what is internet, what are the uses of internet, and what is the real-time communication. All the project details are given in, you have to submit it in Google Classroom. So let us go on to today's class, that is forms. Now what are forms? Forms are another object of the database management system, that is MS Access, and we have learned what are tables and we have understood what are queries. Now let us look at what are forms. Now, forms is an object in Access which helps us to enter, update and add data into the table one record at a time. Now, you know that when I create a table in a database with the different types of fields and record fields, I also need to enter records into the table. Now, how do I, till now, how I was entering the records, it was using the data sheet view. So, I was simply going on adding the records one after the other in the data sheet view. But what happens if I have to enter lot many records, say 5,000, 6,000, 7,000 records? For example, if it is a school of 3,000 students, or if it's a shop or some railway inquiry system like that, I need lots and lots of entry into a table. Then data sheet view becomes a very difficult way of entering data into the table. Secondly, what happens in the data sheet view is that everybody who is doing entry into the records need to get the will have direct access of that particular table, which is very difficult, important part of the database. So in such a case, there is an object which is called as the forms, which is a very user friendly way of entering data into the table one record at a time. It all the records together will not be seen, one record at a time is seen, and the data entry can be done very easily into the tables using forms. Now, as I told you, the data sheet view is a convenient way of entering data into the table, but if the record of number of this thing is very small. But sometimes while working, many different users have to use it and you don't want the table to be exposed to many other people, and everybody entering into the table, entering data into the table can be a very difficult process. So in such a case, we use forms for the entry of the data. Now, forms can be done and can be made using two ways. One is using the form wizard and second is using the design view. But the problem with design, today we are going to learn only how to use forms for the using the wizard. That is because the form design is a more complicated method of doing it. Although it is very much easier and it has got more control, but from a point of view of teaching it online to you, it is a little bit difficult because many students may not be able to understand it. So we have taken up the easier method of doing a form, that is using the form wizard. So the form design we will not be covering. We will be doing it to you next whenever the school reopens and practicals are conducted next year. We will be giving you an update about it, how to do it next year. So this year we are not going to cover the forms using form design. We are going to only stick to form wizard. So please do not get confused if the notes in your textbook contains the design form. We are not covering that. It is omitted. Now, we'll go on how to create a form using the form wizard. Today we are going to learn how to use forms to do data entry into tables. But before we do the forms, let us do a complete revision of how to create a table and how to actually use forms to enter the data. So here we click on a new database. In MS Access, I will click on a new blank data sheet. Here I am going to give the name for the database. That is, let us take ICID Bank. This is the name of the database. So I'm going to make a new database called ICID Bank, which is a bank database. Click on the create button. Now here you get to see the table option over here. That means the first one, I will right click and go to the design view of this table. What name am I going to give? I'm going to give the name called as customer details. So every bank has got some particular customers. So I'm going to give details like of the customer. So I click on OK. Now the design view of the table opens up with the field names and the data type. So my first field name will be customer ID, customer underscore ID. And this is going to be, let's take a text data type, because I may have to have some alphabets in the customer ID, whatever. So I'm giving it as a text data type. The next one will be your account number. So I say AC underscore number, which is the, or I can write the whole account, AC account underscore number. So every customer has got an account number in the bank, and that is going to be purely numeric. Next one is the customer name, that is C name, again a text type, address, again text type, date of birth, that is DOB, which is a date data type, date and time, and we can have another for the mobile number, which is again a number data type. We can also have one more field called as the gender, which could be a text data type, male or female. So this way I have made a structure for the customer details table, and now I'm going to save this table. So when I click on save the table, now this particular item, that is the customer details table, is ready. In our general flow of practice, what do? We will double click on this, and in my data sheet view, I will start entering the records into the table. But here comes the use of the form. Sometimes we do not want the entire details of all the data sheets in the table to be visible to everybody. Or if suppose there are about 5,000 customers, then data entry using the data sheet view is a very difficult activity. Instead of that, we will now do data entry into this particular customer table using forms. How do we create a form? As I told you, we are going to use the form wizard to create form. So I click on the create option and then click on the form group, and in the form group there is form wizard. Now here a dialog box, that is the form wizard window, opens up for me, which contains the name of the table, that is customer details, and all the six fields which I have created. I want one by one I can put it, or all together I will transfer all the fields into the selected field. So these are the fields into which I want to do the data entry. If I do not want to do data entry at one point, I want to give only the account number, then I will select only account number and push it over here. But as of now, I want all the fields into which I want to enter the records. Click on the next button. This being a wizard, it is simply a one by one, step by step instructions to create a form. Click on the next option, and here there are four different designs in which you can do. That is a columnar, tabular, a data sheet view like this, or a justified view. So let us take the columnar view. This way, in column wise, the data can be entered. That is one by one. That is tabular. This is like a table form. The data sheet view, this is the normal view, like how to do, so, and a justified view. So let us take the columnar view. Click on next. Now here, what name are you going to give to this form, what title that is. So you will say customer details data entry form, and that is the title of the form that is going to be there, and click on finish. Now here you see customer, a form by the name customer data entry form comes up, and here you get to see a columnar way of entering single data at a time, that is one record at a time. So here I'll say customer number A001, account number, let's take 3496 or some number which is going to be there, that is suppose like 20109876, customer name Rahul Iyer, say address Thane. I'm just simply doing a small thing, a date of birth in date format. I'm just giving some random date, not very, mobile number, some mobile number, and gender. Gender male. So this is my first record, and when I press the enter key here, and all the details, that is first record, has been entered, I can click here. This bar here will show you how many records are there. One of one record. This will take me to the next record. This will take me to the last record. So suppose if I have got 500 records, I can directly go to the first record from here and the last record from this particular option. A new record, a new blank record, I click on this button here at the end with the yellow color, click. And a new record. So A002. The next account number, something I'm going to write. Random numbers. 1 minute. I think I'm entering enter. Only 9 numbers can be entered in the numeric field. Then let's take a new name. Anita Shah. Address Mumbai. Date of birth. Any date of birth I'm giving. Mobile number, some mobile number, and gender. Oh God, every time I'm doing the same. And female. So this way I have entered two records using a form. So data entry. Now see, if I take click on this first record, it will take me to the first record. Here there are only two records. So it will take me new record. I click on this button over here at the end, new record, and the third record sheet opens up for me. So forms help me to do data entry one record at a time. It also helps me to search through the records very quickly. If I want to go to a particular record number, now in this case I have got very little records, so it will I need not do. But once I close this form, now customer detail form, and I go back to my customer table, the data entry which I did through the form is visible to me in the table. So this is the use of a form. A form helps me to do data entry one record at a time into the table. It is a much better way of doing data entry into the form because it gives you full control. Now after two records, once again the next day, if the clerk wants to come and do more data entry, he will not go to the data sheet view of the table. They can directly open this form, and the form will open up for me, and I can start doing your new record. And I can start doing the third entry. So this way, data entry into forms can be done very easily with the help of data entry into the tables can be done very quickly and easily with the help of these forms. Now, for your convenience, I have done some sort of a data entry into this particular table using the forms. Now, let us go and go back. We can use the forms to update or insert new records. That is, already a form was created and I had entered a few records in it. Now once again I open my form. Now here it takes me to the very first record. Now as of now I have got 9 records, so I can just go. This will take me, I'm on the first record, and this particular button will take me to the last record. So here I have come and record number 10. Now if I want to move in between the records, I can simply press the left arrow key or the right arrow key to move between the records. You can see that the record numbers are changing, and over here I see that in the previous records up to the data entry has been done only up to record number 2. So I can just go to the next record and complete my data entry over here. Your mobile number is not updated, so I will update over here. And this gender also has not been updated, so I can update the record, go to the next record. So this way it helps me move around. Here also the gender and the mobile number has not been updated, so updation can be done very easily using this form. So I'm updating over here the mobile number, random updation I'm doing, and then here female, I'm entering the record, go to the next record. Like this I can keep on updating the records according to my wish. Whenever I want, the clerks can go on. Updation of records can be done. Also, adding of a new record can be done. So, I had only 10 records. So, I'm adding one more record over here. Account number 20198. And some record number I'm adding into the field. And this way I can use my form to enter the records, to update the records, and even to make changes. Suppose in my first record I want to make the change, I can simply go to the very first record, and instead of Rahul Iyer it is Rahul Nair. So I can put Nair over here and update, and once I finish my updation or adding of the records, I can simply save it. Now, when I go to my customer details table, all the records which I had updated over here, see Yamini Gupta I added, Rahul Nair, Iyer has become Rahul Nair, and the few updations which I had done is clearly visible in the customer details table. Once the forms are created, there are 3 different views in which we can see the form. So if I click on the view button, you will see that the form view, layout view and design view. These are the 3 views in which a form can be seen. So if I click on the design view, then it will show me the actual design, and as I told you, the design view is more complicated to be seen. So here this is the labels and this is the actual place where the data is entered. So this is the basic design grid of how a form is to be made. The if I don't want this particular way, I can make any changes to my design using this design view grid. The next views is we can even look at the view from here, that is the layout view, that which helps me to actually make some changes to the size of my the particular thing, or add or delete any particular field. If I do not want it, I can do that using the layout view. And the next view is the design, the actual form view, which helps me to do the data entry into the form. So these are the 3 views in which I can view a form. My form, whenever I create a form, you see here it is a red colored icon. A table has got this type of an icon which looks like an Excel sheet, and you will also realize that queries have got a different logo. So these are the objects which we are learning, that is tables, forms, queries, and the last one, reports, which we will be covering in our next class. So with that, we come to the end of this chapter, and let a quick revision. Forms provide a window into your data and make your database look very polished and professional, and helps to do data entry one record at a time, and data can be inserted, updated and also deleted using the forms in a table. So this is what the chapter on forms is. And as I'm repeating again, we are not doing the forms using form design view. We are doing only forms using form wizard. Thank you.